Eh bien, bonjour, hello, bienvenue à un nouvel épisode de Learn French with a French Guy. So today I have a vignette coming from a French comic book. It's a story about some boxers. And again, it's from the 50s, and I've selected a bubble, so I'm going to focus on the bubble on the right, and the object of the discussion today is going to be about pronoms relatifs dont. When used as a complément d'objet indirect. So C is complément. O is objet. So d'ob. D'objet. I is indirect. It's an R indirect. Okay, so let's focus. I'm not going to talk about this one. I'm just going to focus on this, and the don is here. Right here. So let's read this. Heureusement, tu as gagné l'argent, l'argent de ta bourse nous permettra d'acheter la petite ferme dont nous avons besoin pour finir nos jours. Quick translation. Heureusement, fortunately, tu as gagné. So that's passé composé. You won. L'argent de ta bourse. So the money from the prize nous permettra will allow us d'acheter. Will allow us to buy. La petite ferme, the small farm, dont nous avons besoin, that we need, pour finir, to finish nos jours, our days. So let's look at le don. So let's look at that. So let me start a new page and I'm gonna redo that bubble. So, l'argent de ta bourse, so nous permettra d'acheter la petite ferme, so I'm just going to say la ferme. The farm, la ferme dont nous avons besoin, that we need, dont nous avons besoin. I'm going to stop here. There's more, but doesn't matter. So, l'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme dont nous avons besoin. So, in order to understand why don is used here, as a pronom relatif, you need to split the sentence into two. So l'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme. So that's sentence one. And the second sentence is nous avons besoin de la ferme. So this means that don is pronom relatif. And the antecedent, the noun that is replacing, is here. Okay, so this is complément objet indirect, COI, of this. Actually, you can do it this way. Okay, that's the whole verb here. It's a group verbal. So, so the function of don in that first version, which is what's in a comic book. So don, its function, the function in the sentence is COI of this, part. Okay? So it's COI of nous avons besoin and you use don when the verb uses de as always uses de as the preposition. For instance, se souvenir de dépendre de se moquer de to make fun of se moquer de s'occuper de to take care of rêver de. There's so many of them. Rêver to dream of. Parler de. Etc. Etc. And in our case, in the case of that comic book, it's the verb is avoir besoin. Avoir besoin de. So that counts. It's the same thing. Avoir besoin de. Avoir. Peur de être content de prendre soin de OK, so so either the verb is constructed is always constructed with de as a preposition, or it's like a expression like this. Avoir besoin de, avoir peur de, être content de, prendre soin de. But the important bit is that you have a de as the preposition. De is the preposition. So then you use don as the pronom relatif COI, like in our case, the comic book. Okay. So l'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme dont nous avons besoin. Don is COI of nous avons besoin, and nous avons besoin is constructed with that preposition de. The whole thing, nous avons besoin de. Okay. So it's because of the de. Okay, so don is COI of nous avons besoin. But you may wonder, how come we use don? How come we don't use de laquelle? De laquelle? So let me start a new page and let's talk about this. How come we don't use de laquelle? L'argent nous permet. L'argent nous permettra d'acheter. L'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme. Ok. L'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme dont nous avons besoin. So here it is. So pronom relatif COI of this guy. But if you remember, I made a video about pronom relatif composé. So I'll put a link somewhere on the right, upper right, so that you can click on it. There it goes. Pronom relatif composé is lequel, laquelle, lesquels et desquels. Non, lesquels, sorry. Lesquels. Lesquels. L. So this is masculine singular. This is feminine singular. This is masculine plural. This is feminine plural. And then you have, because here we are talking about the preposition de, you would have the pronom relatif composé contracted. So instead of saying de lequel, you say duquel. De laquelle doesn't change. Desquels. And desquels. So here we have antécédent is this guy, la ferme, which is feminine singular. So this would be de laquelle. So the question is, this is A. How come we don't say l'argent nous permettra d'acheter la ferme de laquelle nous avons besoin? That's a very legitimate question. So let's look at this question, which is often referred as don versus duquel. In our case it would be de laquelle, but duquel is masculine singular, so that's the one we talk about. Don. When do you use don? When do you use duquel? So let's do another page. Duquel. So duquel De laquelle? La sor de laquelle, sorry. No accent. De laquelle? Desquelles? Desquelles? Okay, so this is feminine singular, this is masculine plural, feminine plural, and this is masculine singular. So when do you use duquel? So you use duquel when the preposition is actually what is called a locution. Locution. Locution prépositive, which means that you don't have a single word, you have a group of words as the preposition. For instance, à côté de. See, you don't have just de, you have à côté de. So a group of words as the preposition. Près de, loin de, à propos de, en face de, en face de, en bas de, en haut de. Okay, there's tons like that. Whenever you use a de at the end, so this is a locution prépositive. It's a bunch of words that make up a preposition. Okay, so in our case, if we go back to the vignette. So don is a pronom relatif COI of avons besoin. So because that expression avons besoin needs de as the preposition, that's why you use don as the pronom relatif. So I think I'm gonna stop here because otherwise my videos are become so long, and as a French learner, I do understand that it's tough to understand all the nuances of the language. When you're a native speaker, you don't really know the grammar rules. I mean, you may have known them when you learned them when you were in school, but as an adult, you don't know them. You just use your ear or your instinct or what sounds good as your grammar rule. You don't really know the rule, you just use whatever sounds correct or good. So don't feel bad about all those rules if you don't know them perfectly, because I can guarantee you that 99% of native speakers don't know the rules. They just use what sounds good to them. And more often than not, it's correct. But sometimes it's not, so it's always good to know the proper grammar rules. Okay, so I'm gonna stop here. If you like this kind of videos, please like, comment, subscribe, and that's gonna give me the motivation to make more, because it's not always easy to make those videos, to be honest. I mean, it takes a toll on you. All right, I'm gonna stop here. Bye.